everyone. Long time no see. But I have just been very, very unmotivated to do any YouTube videos lately, just because I feel like I have a lot of makeup fatigue. And I've just had so many new interests and hobbies and activities that have really taken over a lot of my time. But I wanted to at least do a little bit of a catch up with some of my BoxyCharm boxes. I know, to be honest, a lot of people don't really watch my content for BoxyCharm at all, but it's just what I have and what I've been wanting to talk about lately. But I will go through them quickly and share with you everything that I got from my July BoxyCharm and my June BoxyCharm. And I'll use a few things from that and just kind of talk about the beauty community, my thoughts on makeup, honestly, where we're at in the world, my new hobbies and plans and things like that. So this is gonna be a really long video, so definitely get you a snack, get you a drink, and yes, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Really quickly, I will go through all the products that I got in my June Boxy Luxe box. So the theme of this one was the Oasis, and I got variation number 3. So the first thing I got was the Kylie Skin by Kylie Jenner Foaming Face Wash. This retails for $24. And I feel like I just got another foaming face wash in either the box before this or maybe the one before that. So I just, little side note, I hate whenever they give you like such similar items back to back. So that's one thing I don't like, but that one is $24. It's probably gonna be a long time before I even get to it, because I would like to use up the older products I have first. So don't expect a review on any of this anytime soon. Next, I got the Purelease Perfect Glow BB Cream. They actually sent me this one in the color medium instead of light. This one retails for $35, but they did give me a like charm points or something that I can use to spend on other items from the charm shop. So they did send me medium. I actually think this will work for me though. I am just a little bit tanner at the moment. Like my face looks like ghost white compared to my body. But I actually think this color might do me some good. So I do think I will use this one today. Next, I got the Triple X Mascara from Lily Lashes. This retails for $24. I believe this might've been a product that I picked. And I will not be getting to this one anytime soon because again, I have a backlog of mascaras and I'm sorry, I'm not gonna open this one just to show you the wand and start the expiration on that one. So I will probably insert a picture if you want to see what it looks like, but it's probably going to be, I don't know, quite a while until I get to that one. Next, I got a palette. This is the Tartist Pro Amazonian Clay Eyeshadow Palette. This one retails for $49. This one's really pretty. It has like a lot of like matte earthy kind of colors to it, but it does have a few shimmers in it as well. And I feel like this might've been a product I picked as well. This is from Smile Sciences. It's the teeth whitening set. This retails for $80. I feel like that is a huge ripoff, but it looks like this and it does come with two of the little whitening pens. And I think, like I said, I think I picked these out, so I will definitely have to like give these a go. And you know, granted that they don't like make my teeth super sensitive, but you know, I can definitely have a little bit of a wider smile. So that retailed for $80. Next is the M Green Grass CBD Head to Toe Cream. So this I think is just like an all over kind of moisturizer. This retails for $56. That is a huge price tag for this small of a bottle. I don't know how I'm gonna use this. I don't know, I don't really know a whole lot about like CBD products and stuff like that, but I will give it a go and see. But like I said, I'm truly so backlogged on so many products, a lot of BoxyCharm products as well, that I feel like I almost need to like cancel BoxyCharm. But that will be more discussion later. The next thing I have is the Malin & Goetz Recovery Treatment Oil. So it is an oil that looks like this, retails for $82. Again, super, super expensive. But like I said, I get so many of these like serums and oils and stuff back to back in BoxyCharm. Like I have no idea when I'm gonna get to try this, because I truly don't like using 1,000 different products at once and not knowing what's giving me results and what's not. So that is something that will definitely get used in a while. And then the last thing that came in this set was the Bodyography Lip Pencil Set. This is two lip liners. The colors that it comes in is Pouty and Rosewood. So I really like these two colors. Even though like the color Rosewood, I feel like I wouldn't use as much, it is a nice color to have because I do have darker lipsticks that I do not have a lip liner to match with that. So it's nice to have that for every once in a while when I want to do those like really dark kind of lips. But the other color, Pouty, I feel like I would use a ton. I'm actually almost done with a lip liner that I got from BoxyCharm a while ago. This was the Steve Laurent one. It's like almost gone, but I am really trying to work through products and not just have 10 of the same products sitting around. Oh, I didn't see the price of this. $28 for two pencils. Honestly, I think like the cheapest lip liners can work really, really well. Like NYX makes some really great ones that are probably like $2 or $3 a piece. So, I mean, I wouldn't pay that much for these lip liners, but they're definitely gonna get used. So that was everything that I got in my Boxy Luxe box for June. And really quickly, I will go through what I got for my regular BoxyCharm for July. So the theme of this one was sunshine. It's a really cute card. And I got variation number 18. So the first thing I got is the 111 Skin Harley St. London. This is the NAC Y2 Pollution Defense Booster. Okay, I don't really know what that is, but basically to me, it looks like it's another type of like oil serum type of product, like skincare, which this one retails for $135. Again, I don't know, I kind of have to call bullshit on a lot of this stuff. I mean, I'm sure they do sell for that much, but it's definitely, to me, not worth that much money. But again, I hate whenever I get like such similar products back to back, because it's just, it's too much. It's almost overload. So next I got the Hourglass Arch Brow Micro Sculpting Pencil. This one retails for $28. It's one of those teeny tiny little eyebrow pencils. I'm not a huge fan of eyebrow pencils, but I will give this one a go today. And they gave me the color Warm Blonde. Next I got an eyeshadow palette. This one is from Pure. It is the Festival 2.0 eyeshadow palette and it retails for $36. I believe I do have the original Festival palette that they did, I think, last year. The colors in this one are actually really pretty. Definitely a little bit of pops of color in there. It's not like a typical boring neutral palette, but there are definitely a lot of like wearable colors here that I feel like could ground some of these more like really pretty pops of colors. Okay, last two products. So this is from The Cream Shop. This is called the Toasty Cushion Bronzer. So I definitely have had one of these before that I still have, but I will try this one today. I feel like this one would be really pretty. Okay, I don't see a color name on it right now, but this retails for $20. So that's something I'm kind of interested in trying. And then the last thing I got was the Quick Color Switch from Lavish. It is a dry makeup brush cleaner. So if you've never seen one of those before, it's basically this like plasticky kind of like textured stuff that you can use to quickly run your brush over to remove the color from it. So you can, you know, use that same brush without having to clean it. I've always wanted one of these, but I would never spend as much money as this. This one was $17. I mean, you could get like literally things from the dollar store that are like the exact same thing as this, so don't splurge on this type of thing. But it is nice that I have it in my collection now because I didn't have one of these before. The only thing is I wish it was a lot smaller. Like it could be like, I don't know, it could be like a third of the size and still do the job, because I just, my makeup has to be very travel friendly now because I am like traveling every weekend and stuff. So I don't have room to carry something this big in my makeup bag. So I wish it was a little bit smaller. I do have another little tin like this that is quite a bit smaller that I might just like cut this up and like make it fit that one. But it is a handy thing to do. I would never spend that much money on it. But yeah, that is everything that I got from my July and my June BoxyCharm boxes. So I'm just gonna start, go through, pick some things I wanna use and just kind of talk. So I hope you guys enjoy that. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna use, this is actually not a BoxyCharm product. This is from Etude House. This is the Fix and Fix Primer. I think I did a review on this a long time ago, but I'm like almost done with it. And like I said, I am truly trying to stick to like one type of primer, one type of foundation, one type of blush, one type of, you know, everything, and really work through the products, because honestly, I'm just kind of tired of having so much stuff, and I'm the person that I do not like stuff to go to waste. And I know I will never be able to use all this makeup in my entire lifetime, so I already feel very regretful about having so much. So I'm just really trying to work on using up what I have and trying to be better at not bringing in more makeup, which is why I kind of want to consider canceling BoxyCharm. Because not because I'm not happy with the service or I don't think it's worth the money or anything like that. I think it really is. I mean, I'm kind of biased because I haven't tried any other makeup subscription boxes, so I mean, take that with a grain of salt, everything I say. But I really do think the products that you get for the money you pay is a really good deal with BoxyCharm. So it's not at all me saying like, oh, BoxyCharm sucks and I'm just tired of it. No, it's really just, honestly, I have been subscribed for over 2.5 years now, I think. And it's just too much, man. It's just too much. As much as I love getting like a new box every month of stuff, it truly is just too much for me. And maybe if it was like, I wish you could like sign up and do like a every quarter kind of thing. Like, I don't know if you can, but if you could like do just like a Boxy Luxe at once every 3 months, I would be much more apt to sign up for that, just because honestly, it's a lot. It's so much. And I'm really starting to feel overwhelmed, and it's stressing me out now. I also think with social media and the rate that we watch videos, especially beauty videos, it makes you want to buy more. And even if you don't realize it, I don't know, it's just, it's too much now. Okay, so I'm gonna try the Pureless Perfect Glow BB Cream. Like I said, this one is in the color medium. And like I said, hopefully it'll kind of match me a little bit better because I am a little bit tanner now. Interested to see like what the coverage of this is gonna be like. So I'm just gonna start with a little bit, about that much. And I'm going to just kind of dot this on my face. So, but like I was saying about just feeling very overwhelmed when it comes to beauty content and stuff. Like, I still love watching beauty videos. Like, they really are my one favorite type of thing to watch. But it's just too much. Like, every video is always trying to sell you something. Not always, but you know, a good portion at least of the videos I watch, the people I watch, it's always about bringing in new things and, you know, trying out the latest, greatest things that is really something that you probably already own, or, you know, has been done 1,000 times over, just a different packaging. Or, you know, at the end of the day, there's really only so much makeup that can come out. And it's truly just, it's really overwhelming to me at this point. And I definitely know a lot of that. If I had never like started a YouTube channel and like had like a beauty focus channel, I definitely would not own as much makeup as I do, because through the years I definitely found that haul videos are really one of the easiest, cheapest, not cheap as in the money you spend on it, but cheap like content wise that you can create. Like, there's no real creativity that comes from a haul video, and I'm 1,000% guilty of that. There's just, you know, you sit down and you're like, hey, here's what I bought. Here's where I got it. Maybe here's how much I paid for it. And then, you know, sometimes you might never see that product again. And I am 1,000% guilty of that, because I have definitely, you know, I like buying new things. I like seeing what there is. And that's always been something that I've liked. And I use the things that I have, but I'm definitely not using them at the rate that I'm bringing them in. And I do not, like I said, I do not like wasting things. I feel very guilty on it. For my concealer, I'm using the Pretty Vulgar concealer that I got in one of my BoxyCharm videos. It's not my favorite concealer, but like I said, I'm really trying to work on using up things that I have. So it's not my favorite, but it works. It gets the job done. It's not as full coverage as I would like, but it is a really good skin tone match, which I was super surprised. Okay, so that is how the Perfect Glow BB cream looks on me. Definitely not too dark. So even though they didn't give me the light color, they gave me medium, which I'm not medium in anything. So I was really surprised. They kind of did like a oops, and that's why they gave me the credit and stuff, which I ended up buying two things from BoxyCharm. One is something I got before in my BoxyCharm. It's the Everyday Vacay Coconut Setting Powder. This was the original one that I got, and I still have quite a bit left. But I did buy a backup of it was like $6 on sale, and so I just used the BoxyCharm credit that they gave me to get that. So that's a product that I really, really love. And then I ended up getting, I think this was also, this might have been $12, I can't remember, but this was the Storybook Cosmetics one in the Little Red Riding Hood. So it looks like that. I have all three of them now. I bought the Robin Hood one, I have the Red Riding Hood, and the Briar Rose one that I got, I think, last December in a Boxy Lux. So I wanted to, like, complete the collection. And, you know, again, like I said, with going back with not needing to buy more makeup, every once in a while I do end up buying more makeup and stuff. But I'm really, really have been trying to make an honest effort to not buy as much stuff, because, I mean, you can see everything behind me. I have so much stuff that I will never use up in my lifetime. And okay, so the next thing I'm gonna use, this was from the BoxyCharm box. This is the Toasty Cushion Bronzer. Like I said, I have used one of these before, but I do want to try it again and see what this one is like. So it's really cute. It's a little compact. It's got the little sponge. I never really use these sponges though. They're just not my favorite, especially for applying like a bronzer type product. But this is what the cushion looks like. I don't know how dark this is actually gonna be, because it's very deceptive in the packaging. But I'm gonna apply it with a brush like this to blend it. I don't know if that's what I want to use to put it on. Okay, I'm just gonna do it that way. So I'm just gonna pick some of it up and I'm gonna apply it and see what I can do with it. One thing I do have to say though about the Purelease BB cream, I don't know if it's just maybe I didn't blend it very well, but it did kind of look a little bit patchy on my skin. That's again probably just my fault for not blending it very well. And another thing, I have just been from day to day, I really do not wear much makeup anymore. I will do a little bit of foundation, I'll do like some brows and a little bit of mascara and maybe like just a lip gloss or something, but I really haven't been wanting to wear much makeup at all. Ooh, okay, now I think I might have overdone it. I used my beauty sponge to do this, so I'm gonna have to really blend this out, man. But yeah, from the day to day, I'm just really not wearing too much makeup anymore. One, because it's like it's summer and it's hot as hell and I'm just going to work where no one sees me anyways. But yeah, so I really haven't been too much into makeup lately, and I do kind of go through those phases where, you know, it's just all I care about is makeup and that's all I want to do, and then, you know, I'll kind of have a moment where it's like, I'm just not really into makeup at the moment. It's just been a really crazy year. For anyone who doesn't know, I do taxes, so this year really kind of put a ringer in the plan, because tax season usually runs from, you know, like January to mid-April, but this year it got extended all the way till July 15th, which just passed, so it was very drawn out and a lot different, and then for it to be such an irregular year tax-wise really kind of put a lot of stress on me, and you know, I'm working like 6 days a week and then the extension happens and then it really kind of threw off my work hours, then coronavirus. It was just really truly so much stuff going on, all happening at once, dealing with like a long distance boyfriend and, you know, quarantine and stuff and not being able to go see him, and then finally stuff starts opening up and feeling comfortable and going to see him, and then shit hits the fan. It's really just been, it's been a whirlwind of a year, and I feel like it's not getting better. It's not getting better, and it's just really kind of stressful and something that kind of keeps me up at night. And I know everyone's going through the same thing, and I'm so fortunate to have not personally known or have lost anyone to the virus or anything. And I'm so extremely fortunate for that, but it is a very scary thing, and thinking like, okay, how can I do my best to, you know, stay home when I can, not going anywhere unless it's absolutely necessary, and always, always, always wearing a mask. I strongly urge everyone to wear a mask, because there's truly just so much data that how much the transmission rate can be slowed down truly just from the simple act of wearing a mask. The important part is you're wearing it to protect others. I just wish everyone would have the decency and the courtesy to wear a mask and show that respect that I'm doing this for you. And I just feel like there's so many people in this world, not this world, this country, that truly do not see that, and they think, oh well, it's my choice and I can wear a mask and I don't have to wear it and it's against my freedoms. And I'm sorry if you're one of those people. I completely 100% disagree with you. It's a very scary time, and the least thing you could do is just to wear a mask if you're going to go out. Luckily now a lot of states have started actually mandating masks, which is a very, very good thing. That kind of gives me a little bit of a peace of mind. Of course people have to follow the mandate, but it really is a little bit of a sense of relief to know more people are going to be wearing masks. And honestly, it's just, it's such a scary time. I don't like leaving the house. I don't like going anywhere unless it's necessary. And it's really hard just feeling so cooped up all the time, and not being able to just go do something fun. You know, like I can't just go watch a movie or just go eat at my favorite restaurant. It's like, yeah, I can do pickup and stuff, and I'm trying to get back on my diet anyway, so it's really hard to not let quarantine just totally wreck my my progress with my diet, which is another thing. Pretty much since I started dating my boyfriend last year, actually we just celebrated our first anniversary, so that was very exciting. But pretty much since I started dating him, I have pretty much plateaued with my weight loss, and I've actually gained just a little bit back. I've probably gained about 10 pounds since I started dating him, but I have lost a little bit of that back. So I'm just trying to be better at sticking to my diet, which is hard to do because obviously like we like making food and really good food and not keto stuff, even though we could, especially since I go stay with him now. Now that my work hours have changed a bit, I do have like Fridays off and stuff, so I usually go see him and I'll stay with him for the weekend, so I'm there a lot of the time. Okay, so now I'm gonna try out the Hourglass Arch Brow. So like I said, I'm not really a fan of eyebrow pencils. I will give this one a go. I like that it does have the little spoolie brush on the side, so it's nice and compact. So I'm just gonna kind of brush through my brows just a little bit. But like I said, dieting, it's really hard when like all you want to do is just like eat really good food with your boyfriend. So I'm trying to be better at that and sticking to my diet a little bit better and not being like, if I'm gonna do a cheat day, it's gonna be like a one day, you know, not a whole weekend like I was doing. I would, you know, cheat all weekend on my diet and then come home and try to do good Monday through Thursday and then just blow it all again. So I definitely have stalled a lot of progress from that, but I have been very consistent this week and I have lost like 5 pounds in a week. I just want to like try to get back to more balance, and I know that like quarantine has really thrown a lot of this off because you're just depressed and you're sitting at home and like all you can do is just sit home and eat, and you know, especially if you are someone like me who's an emotional eater, like it really gets to you and it's just not, it's not fun. It's not fun. Okay, so I actually really kind of like this eyebrow pencil. It's really pretty. It looks super natural. I feel like sometimes I tend to go really crazy on my brows. The only thing is I feel like I would blow through this product so quick just because how tiny this little pencil is. Like, it's truly, like, tiny. Like, it's smaller than a grain of rice, probably. Yeah, I would definitely say that's smaller than a grain of rice. So, the amount of product you get for the price you pay for these like high-end eyebrow pencils are absolutely ridiculous. But I think like now there's definitely so many brands that make these kind of like micro pencil eyebrow pencils that are much more of a reasonable price, so you don't have to pay a ridiculous amount of money for products like this. Okay, so that is how my eyebrows look. I actually really like how this looked. I feel like it looks a lot more natural than I typically do. So I actually really do like this, so I might have to give this more of a try. So I'm gonna actually put this in my makeup bag and dedicate a little bit more use to that one. I really do like that product, so I'm really glad I got that. Okay, so between the two palettes I got, I have the TARDIS Pro palette and I have the Festival palette. I didn't know which one I wanted to do. At first I was kind of leaning towards the TARDIS palette, which is very, very pretty, but it is like 99% mattes. So these are all of the colors here. All the square ones are matte and then you get 4 shimmers on the side. Very pretty, like wearable palette, but I kind of feel like, although like I know all the time I do like boring like neutrals and stuff, I don't know, I just kind of feel like I want to do the Festival palette. Okay, so first I'm gonna start by priming my eyes. This one is just the Etude Proof 10 eyeliner, not eyeliner, eyeshadow primer. I don't really care for this one too much, but like I said, I'm trying to use it up. Okay, so first things, I'm going to use the color switch. I have my blending brush here, has a little bit of color on here, so I'm just gonna run this over here, kind of like that, to remove the eyeshadow color from it. So my brush is definitely still stained, but it definitely is not like coming off any color on there, so that is good. So I think the first color I'm going to use, let's see, I'm gonna always have to start a little basic, but I'm gonna go with the color Photo Op. So it's this color here. Pick some of that up. It's a little bit powdery. I like Pure's eyeshadows. I've only tried a few of them, but I do like them, but they are pretty pigmented, but they definitely are very powdery eyeshadows. So you don't wanna like just dig your brush into these types of eyeshadows because you will just like go straight to the pan. So another thing recently has been like absolute drama in the beauty community, which, you know, on the one hand, it's like, there are so much more important things in the world to be going on, which I totally get that point of view, but it's like, this stuff also matters. Like, people, like, trying to take people down, it's so, on the one hand, it sounds so ridiculous when you talk about it and you think about, like, real life. It's so petty, in my opinion. Everyone involved, just absolutely everyone involved is so petty in this situation. And it really disgusts me. I was talking about this the other night with my friend. We were just sitting in her backyard, 6 feet apart, just chatting till like 1 a.m. around a campfire. And we were just kind of talking about like, you know, celebrities and stuff like that and just how detached from reality they are. And it's just crazy at the amount of idolization that people have for like the Kardashians or, you know, you name it, whoever. You know, young, impressionable kids and like teenagers and stuff, and just how much they look up to the absolute worst people ever. And it's of course like not everyone's gonna be like this perfect role model, but I find it to be especially true with YouTubers, you know, who are like not really celebrities in the traditional sense, but they are definitely celebrities like on the internet, on YouTube, on Instagram, whatever it may be, just social media influencers, all of the above. It's just ridiculous at the level of power that they have. Honestly, the bad decisions that people make when it comes with power, I cannot relate to it on any level, that I don't get it. Like the people who love like the Jake Pauls of the world and stuff like that, and who are just all about them, I don't get it. I don't get it. Okay, I'm gonna use a little bit of this classic color from the Tarte palette just to kind of lighten up the edge and blend that a little bit more. But going back to the whole like YouTube drama, like the Shane, the Jeffrey, the James Charles, the Tati, all of that stuff, like again, it feels weird even talking about it. And it's just ridiculous, especially whenever like Shane originally came out with that whole like, I'm leaving the beauty community thing. Like that was so weird to me, because it's like, how do you leave a community you were never in? And just like blanket statementing the whole like beauty community. And I was watching another video the other day, I think it was Jessica Braun. She had mentioned in one of her videos that, you know, there, yes, of course, there is the beauty community, but there really are like neighborhoods within that community that really are completely different. Like you have all of the top creators that are, you know, like catty or just so out of touch with reality, that are millionaires, that don't understand what like a regular struggle of life is or whatever, you know. Not to say that all of them are that way, but there are definitely a good portion that are, that have just truly lost touch with reality. And then you have the people like ones that I love to watch, like Emily Noel and Jen Love's reviews and Jessica Braun and just a million other, Smokey Glow, a million other people that do content that not necessarily has to be like wholesome, like nothing ever is wrong, no controversies and stuff, like very cookie cutter, picket white fence, whatever, but just people that truly understand like what it is to be a normal person and to not let YouTube fame or YouTube whatever or influence to really change them as a person. Good role models, good people to look up to, good people that like you could truly see yourself being friends with in real life, and not some crazy, over the top, cannot relate to real life anymore, you know, those types of people. I've never been drawn to that type of content, so I really don't watch a whole bunch of people that have that extreme lavish lifestyle, you know, with tens of millions of followers, because that's just never spoke to me. Having like, okay, so yeah, you've got the cool stuff, you've got the nice house. On the surface level, that is interesting, because honestly, that's like, yeah, I'll never have that, and I'll never live in a mansion like that, but that's okay. So from the surface level, it is interesting to see, but you know, when that's all you've got to give, it's just like, oh, here, look at all my cars for the 10th time. That just gets really stale, superficial, and honestly boring. So I get the people that do like to see those types of videos and contents and those creators and stuff, and I don't blame you for that at all, but to me it just does not speak to me. So whenever I see like those Jeffree Star videos of like spending thousands of dollars and, you know, just whatever it may be, it truly just does not speak to me. I forgot to say I did use this darker color here. This one is called Onset to deepen the crease. Now I'm gonna move on to the color Utopia here. That one looks so pretty. I want to pat that right there. Yeah, I can definitely see this is a color that would look a lot better just applying it with my finger. Like, look at that. Oh my gosh, look at the difference that that made. But going back to what I was saying, it's like, oh, what? Oh, another person said a catty thing about someone else. And it gets ridiculous, especially to the point when it's coming to like unsubstantiated claims that like could literally ruin someone's life and stuff like that. It's just, it's an absolutely ridiculous thing. And I can't believe that. Well, I can believe that, you know, the drama is what rises to the top when it comes to YouTube and what people want to watch, and it's so sad. Okay, and then I'm going to do the color here. This one's called Euphoric. It's like a champagne-y kind of shimmer color. I'm just going to take a little bit of that on my brush and kind of do that on the inner portion of my little inner corner here. So going back to like the whole YouTube drama thing, really I just feel like in general it's just rewarding bad behavior, and it kind of just grinds my gear. Like, I don't watch those people because I don't want to reward their bad behavior and give them, you know, clicks and views and put money into their pocket just because, like, oh, I want to know what this person said and what this person said. It's like, it's really disgusting to me. And it goes so much farther than just, you know, YouTube celebrities or, you know, real life celebrities. It's just like, I don't know, maybe I'm just a grandma now, but I really, truly do not give any fucks about any of that drama. It's just so unproductive and disgusting. So like I've been saying, I have been kind of makeup fatigued lately. So I have not been putting a lot of time into buying makeup or trying new makeup or even putting on makeup or let alone making YouTube reviews or videos or anything. But what I have been doing lately that has been so much fun for me has been making soap. So if you don't know about me, I am a very, very crafty person. I love doing all types of crafts. I have done so many. I've done like candle making, I have done sewing, embroidery, cross stitch, screen printing, clay molding, I have done soap, I do stickers. What else have I done? Jewelry making, I mean like literally knitting, crocheting, so much stuff, like so much stuff. I've always been a crafty person. And when I was 16, I started doing soap. And I only did like the melt and pour kind of soap and stuff, and I did it for a little bit, and then I never did it again. I always wanted to do cold process soap, but to be honest, it scared the living night out of me. So I never did. But back when quarantine started, probably around like March or so, I got into watching a new channel and I absolutely love her. It's Katie Carson of Royalty Soaps, and she makes the most amazing cold process soap you have ever seen in your whole damn life. And she is one of those people that like is such a down to earth. She's kind of goofy at times and she's just herself, and it's so authentic and so real and not like I'm putting on a show for everybody. It's just, she's so not that type of person. She's just the realest person ever. And I love that because it shows through in her videos. And she, like I said, not only is she such a good, like, realistic, like, good-natured person, but even more so, she makes videos showing all the soaps that she makes and the soaps that she sells. She'll tell you everything she can. She literally created her own, like, soap recipe and shares it with everyone. You know, she does not, like, try to hide it or be secretive. Like, she is so transparent to everything that comes from her, you know, making her soap, to how she packages it, to how she creates the labels, how she just, the everything that goes along with her creating her business. And she shares that for free with people. And I like watched her videos and I loved them and I was so enthralled. And I remember like, oh, I remember when I used to make soap, that was so much fun, but I never did cold process soap because honestly, lie, it scared the hell out of me. Like that stuff will burn through your skin. So it always scared me and I never took the plunge to do soap. And then after watching like pretty much every video she uploaded, I was like, you know, I really want to go back and give this a go and try and see if it's something that I like. And she made that so easy because, like I said, she shares like everything. Like there's very, very few things that she does not just give away. She shares, you know, her suppliers, where she gets stuff from, what color she uses, and all kinds of stuff like that. And I've never found someone who has owned a business that has so readily just given, I mean, honestly, just shared their hard work, their secrets, their, you know, so many people are so secretive about their stuff. You know, people would ask her like, hey, you own a business and you sell soap. Why would you be like potentially educating your audience on how to become your competitors and stuff like that? And she says, well, you know, to be honest, I am only one person and there are 7 billion people on this planet. I cannot make soap for 7 billion people. I cannot alone supply enough soap for the entire world. So of course there's going to be other people that can do what she's doing. And she doesn't let the fact that, yeah, giving all of your secrets and everything you've learned, just like kind of giving that away to people, sure, it could create more competition for her, but of course, at the end of the day, she's the creative person coming up with, you know, her designs and her stuff. And if at the end of the day, if you can't be that creative factor, it doesn't matter if you know all the secrets. If you can't be that creative original thing, it doesn't matter if you know what printer she uses or where she gets her soap supplies and stuff like that. She really, really inspired me to start making soap myself. And you guys know I have a sticker store that I do, and I'm still doing that and I'm still creating new designs, but I did want to open a new shop for my soaps that I've been making. I have been having so much fun doing this. It's such a fun, honestly therapeutic thing, and I have not felt this excited about something in a long time. And it's like I'll come home from work and all I want to do is just like design and create and brainstorm new bars of soap I want to do, and how do I make it, and what supplies do I need to get, and how do I create it, and stuff like that. And it's been so refreshing for me over the past like month and a half that I've been doing it. I do have a new shop. It's under like the same kind of a company as my sticker name of Velvet Paper Company, but this one is like a little off branch of it, and it's the Velvet Soap Company. So I do have a separate Etsy for that, and I wanted to show you guys some like pictures and stuff of the soaps that I have created and soaps that are going to be coming to my shop soon. Of course, with soaps, they do have to cure for about a month, so it does take quite a while to produce, whereas my stickers, you know, I design the stickers in a couple hours and I manufacture them myself, so it's a quick turnaround from ideation to final product. It's totally different with soap. But yeah, I do have a few bars to sell right now on my Etsy shop, so if you guys are interested in checking it out, and even just looking at it would be a huge thing to me, just to you know, share it with your friends or anything like that, that would be so greatly appreciated. But I have had so much fun, and it's really been one of those things that has been so cathartic for me, and something I really look forward to, and something that really just kind of like reawakened like my creative side. If you guys would like to see these soaps I have created, I'll have some pictures on screen, some stuff that's coming, and I just really look forward to making more and sharing stuff. Okay, so finally I'm going to use the Bodyography Pouty Lip Pencil. I'm just gonna kind of line up my lips with that. Okay, so that is how the lip liner looks on its own. I really like this one. Like I said, I wouldn't pay this much for it, but it's a really nice balance between not being so creamy that it slides all over the lip, but it's dry enough to really like kind of hold it in. So I'm gonna do a little bit of lipstick on top, and oh my god, you guys, look at this. This is screwed all the way up. I am almost done with this lipstick. I never use up a lipstick, but like I said, using up what I have makes me so happy and so fulfilled, and I'm really just trying to be better at using what I have. All right, so that is it for the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was very long awaited, just kind of like a rambly, chatty video. I haven't done a video in almost a month now, and I really have missed it, but I just have not had that motivation. So yeah, I'm not promising anything, but I do want to make more videos. It's just like timing and making it happen, and again, you know, having all these new hobbies and things that I want to really funnel a lot of work and time into, I just can't truly do everything. So I really hope you guys found this video at least a little bit entertaining, just on my thoughts on things. I can tell this is probably gonna be a super, super long video, so I'm gonna try to cut it down as much as I can, but it really was just, I haven't talked in a long time, and I just kind of really wanted to, I don't know, put my thoughts out there and just kind of discuss things that I've missed and, you know, things, and just, I don't know, just talk about stuff that I haven't really talked about. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram, link is below. Check out my new shop if you would like. It will be linked below, as well as my sticker shop. So all kinds of things. If you like soap and you like stickers, check out my Etsy stores, please. That would be so greatly appreciated. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram, link is below. And until my next video, I will talk to you guys later. Bye.